This whole subject of who we are, you know, as atheists, intrigues me also. So I figured I'd make a video response. You know, your last words, passionate and curious. I get the passionate part, but the curious part is that's my failure as an atheist, maybe, because I don't have any curiosity. I mean, people have probably noticed that, the people who've seen some of my videos, they might have drawn that conclusion. I don't even read books anymore. I don't, it's like I have every answer I need. I have no driving curiosity at all. And it's kind of a weird position, because my whole life I was sort of trying to verify, at least, you know, find the evidence or the proof of different things just to make my own argument stronger. And then I sort of realized that there's a certain futility in this, that it's not so much about the character of the argument, the quality of it, the detail of it, the strength of it, even as a intellectual thing. The integrity of it, I don't know the right word here. It's more about personality. I mean, unfortunately, there's so much marketing involved in how humans or people acquire their understanding. And, you know, maybe there's a rare percentage of us who can't see the world that way. We just can't buy anything without picking it apart. You know, I mean, as a kid, I broke everything. Everything you put near me, I broke, because I had to know how it worked. You know, I mean, I was just always in trouble, because, you know, it was like they'd put something on the mantle and I'd be, yeah, gotta find out what the hell that is, and gotta break it, gotta see what it's made of, see how it works, see how it's put together. And so taking anything at a face value or because somebody else said it just never really fit for me. I mean, I had to know it. I couldn't just accept it. As you know, as atheists, it's like, yeah, we are, there's not just breeds of atheists. We come in different species, you know, we are distinct species. And unfortunately, yeah, we just have this one word to describe us. And some other people have some new words, apparently bright and, you know, whatever. And unfortunately, I haven't found another word that really says it. But I always had a perception in my head of atheist. And of course, we all might draw the simple conclusion, oh yeah, atheist is the car thief, murdering scumbag, because obviously don't believe in God or they wouldn't be evil, you know. But I never really paid attention to that example of an atheist. I mean, my examples were always the Einsteins and the Darwins and the, you know, the scientists, the people who took life seriously and took it for what it is. And so I always, the synonyms for atheist for me were intelligence and logic and truth and science. And then, you know, being introduced to this community of atheists, you get the, you know, you get a real feel for people. You know, it's not just talk anymore. You see these people and see what they really are about. And, you know, it's just, that's not what most atheists are. Generally speaking, they tend to be more educated and they tend to be a little more respectful of science, but that key word, passion, sometimes that's lacking. And they are, you know, there's still a lot of searching going on for atheists in terms of meaning, and so they're still, they grasp at things that are, you know, they go from being somebody who might believe in God to somebody who believes in UFOs or some other manifestation of God, you know, some other thing out there that's going to project onto them purpose. You create purpose. You don't look for it. You I mean, of course, you have to look for what needs to be done, but that's sort of, it's the need word. It's just, that's your purpose. Your purpose is to fill what you recognized as the thing you need to do. And that's what drives or should drive any human being, whether they have faith or they don't have faith. And that's sort of the corruption of religion, I suppose, for me, was always this idea that if these people really believe this stuff, why aren't they acting differently? Because I would read the book, and the book would say one thing, and I'd look in the real world and I'd say, well, people aren't doing what the book is saying, so what is that? The thing I'm trying to work out in this whole community is trying to identify who's who. Who's an atheist who has a passion about doing something, and who's an atheist who's just, jerking off, whatever. I mean, who's just, they're not doers, they're just beers, and so their atheism is just kind of irrelevant because there is no passion. Maybe through, if they have enough curiosity, they will acquire passion eventually because they will go through the process of discovery. And like I said, 20 years ago, I was curious. Today, I'm not curious. So that's a, we do change with how much we do absorb and how comfortable we become with our own ideas. And so once you've lived with an idea for 30 years or more, you start to say, yeah, that's a pretty solid idea because it's not going anywhere. It's a conclusion I draw and nothing's breaking it. So it's there, it's solid. You can depend on it. And you gain a sense of confidence. And it sort of changes the equation a little. For me, the consequence of being an atheist, I guess this is where I get into trouble with some parts of this community, because we're not supposed to be judgmental. We're not supposed to presume that atheism should mean anything more than not believing in God. And to me, there's a logical disconnect, because to me, if you respect science, then you have to respect where it leads us. And it doesn't have no values. It doesn't. It's not just science. I mean, it's a discovery of truth. And I think there are some truths discovered through science. I mean, they're sort of objective truths. I mean, we can sort of draw some conclusions. And I could just make the simple argument that we know certain things. I mean, pain is bad. And it's worth preventing, it's worth avoiding if we can do that. And that's sort of it sounds almost like an infantile conclusion, but everybody projects so much crap on everything, like, oh yeah, you have to have the pain or the pleasure doesn't mean anything, and you have to have this and you did it. And so they make all kinds of justifications for things, but I mean, it's sort of just it's like the 2 + 2 of the universe here. That this is not a good thing, that it'd be better to acquire understanding through some other mechanism than horror. It's not a good way to be educated. And the knowledge is the knowledge. I mean, a memory of suffering or an image of it is much more manageable than the actual thing. I mean, who wants to learn the hard way when we can know the easy way? I mean, it's so much more preferable to understand, to just be able to, this is another one of these tragedies of life, is that we live a life and you acquire this understanding, it's all for nothing. It all turns into vapor. It all just disappears. And if I could, you just wish you could take some of the perfect part, some of the clear understanding part, the stuff where you can just see it so perfectly and preserve it, put it in a jar and be able to give it to other people so they could gain that vantage point, to have that perspective. It's almost like somebody could, climb Mount Everest, and put the experience in a bottle and just give it to somebody else, and then they won't have to go break their leg and freeze to death and do all this other crap to get to the top of Mount Everest. Instead, they just, open the bottle and, take a whiff and, oh yeah, I get it. Wow, that was really interesting. That's sort of, I mean, it's just that's where, we each have to restart this stupid understanding engine, with each new life. It just starts from scratch again, it's always from scratch, it's always from nothing, and you're always building it back up and building it back up and building it back up. And we do become smarter over time because we're able to gain some knowledge, but you can't really put so many experiences, you can't put them in a bottle, you can't put them in a book, you can't put them in five paragraphs of text. There's just no way to convey them in some perfect way. And it's irritating.